Alright, so today we are playing Resident Evil 2. This is UI Goku 88. I will be playing hard mode on Resident Evil 2, so like and subscribe if you like this video, and let's play Resident Evil 2 hard mode.
Like and subscribe if you like this video.
Serious, okay? I saw this with my own eyes.
Oh, I believe you, buddy. I believe you. Just tell us a story.
Okay, well, it was last Friday night. I was walking home from the bar, and this woman started coming towards me. She was staggering, you know, so I figured she was drunk.
Whoa. Okay, tell us, be honest now. How many drinks did you have?
No, man, I barely had a buzz on.
Oh, come on.
Look, just listen, all right? She got closer, and I got a good look at her. You had to see her eyes. Her nose, her whole face, it looked like it was rotting.
Yeah.
She looked like a corpse, like a walking corpse, man.
Sounds like my wife.
I've never seen anything like it. I haven't been able to sleep since that night.
All right, calm down, buddy, calm down. Just, hey, you gotta stay strong, okay? Don't give in to fear out there, right?
Yeah, well, you got that right. If you freeze up around these things, they'll sink their teeth in you. I saw attacks of rain.
Oh, come on. Just getting good.
One's around. That's weird. Anybody there?
Something's not.
You all right? Don't move. I'll be back for you.
Stop moving.
Officer, you need help?
Stay back, sir. I got this.
Hey! Wait now!
Help me!
I'll shoot!
As you can see, it's not easy.
Hello? Anybody there? You all right? Don't move. I'll be back for you. Freeze! I'll shoot!
Oh shit. Not yourself.
Don't shoot!
Get down!
So, thanks.
You can thank me later, when we're safe.
Holy shit.
I don't know. Hopefully they'll have some answers at the police station.
Wait, you're a cop?
Yeah, Leon Kennedy. And you are?
Claire. to Redfield.
Live around here?
No. I'm looking for my brother. He's a cop, too.
Well, it's a good thing we found each other. I don't know what to expect anymore.
Attention all citizens. Due to the citywide outbreak, you are advised to take shelter at the Raccoon City Police Station. Free food and medical supplies will be provided to everyone in need.
To know that you got a bunch of cars in Raccoon City, I go back the other way.
Police station's not much farther.
That you got a bunch of cars.
They love something.
Yeah, but what if we're the only ones? What if there's no survivors?
No, there's survivors. Big city. There has to be. Looks like we're walking from here.
This part I'm just gonna have to run.
Can't stay here, it's not safe!
Go on ahead! I'll meet you at the station!
I'll be there!
Ooh, shit.
This is out of control! Everybody. They've all turned. There it is. The station.
There's just no point on trying to shoot. Yoink. Yoink. Yeah.
Hello?
Right, let's see if this gets any easier. Is anybody here? Oh, wow. So I know this game has the unlimited ammo, but you know, if it's an end game and you got advantage, take it. All right, so for right now, we really ain't got. A knife or anything except for the one that I have in my. Box, so I mean, only way to be able to take care of that, to be honest, is
there has to be someone here. Not good.
Yeah, I already know what's behind here. Be like, Charlo was acting weird. Sorry about that, guys. Controller was acting weird.
Jesus.
Oh, you know this will get ugly.
Hurry! Open up! Open this goddamn door! I'll get you out! Please!
Give me your hand.
Help me!
I got you.
Give me your other hand. Jesus Christ.
Oh, he's dead. Because it's in a harder difficulty, Sam. Maybe that's what I should have done at the beginning of the game, just shoot out his legs because they can be disassembled.
Come on.
is safe. For now.
Thanks.
Marvin Browner.
Leon Kennedy. There was another officer I couldn't.
Here. I'm sure you did what you could, Leon.
Does anyone know what started this?
Not a clue. But honestly, all you need to know is that this place will eat you alive if you aren't careful.
Yeah, well, I was supposed to start last week, and I got a call to stay away. I wish I'd come here sooner.
You're here now, Leon. That's all that matters.
Okay, Lieutenant. I'm ready.
Hopefully you'll be able to find a way out of this station. That officer you met earlier, Elliot. He thought this secret passageway might do the trick.
This is good news. We can get you to a hospital.
No, I am not the priority here.
Lieutenant, I'm not just gonna leave you here.
I'm giving you an order, rookie. You save yourself first. I'd come with you, but I just slow you down. Now, you'll need this.
Can't take it.
Stop. And don't make my mistake. If you see one of those things, uniform or not, you do not hesitate. You take it out, or you run. Got it?
Yes, sir. This is not how I imagined my first day.
On your first day? Or in a zombie apocalypse?
Shit! What the hell?
Records of events. September 25th, returning the station into a temporary shelter due to the massive sudden outbreak. All police personnel have been instructed to make the safety of the citizens their top priority as we try to accommodate as many of them as possible. September 25th, addendum. I'm not gonna read all this, but evidently it's from David Ford. Oh god. Give me just a minute, chat.
Daddy.
Cindy, you do see what I'm doing, right? Okay.
bitch.
What in the...
Are you okay, Marvin?
I've got something to show you. It's important.
Copy that. I'll be right there. God damn it. What the? Back up. I can do this.
There you are. Come here. Take a look.
Yes. I knew she'd make it.
Oh, you know her?
Yeah. Name's Claire. I came into town with her.
You can get to that courtyard. Through the second floor. East side.
I'm on it. Thanks, Lieutenant. on. I'll be right there.
Okay.
Claire. It's so nice to see you.
How are you doing? That helicopter just came out of nowhere.
I'm in one piece.
I'm guessing you don't have a key in one of those fancy pockets?
Unfortunately, no. Mm. But how are you doing?
You know, just surviving.
That's good.
Yeah.
Any luck with your brother?
No, not yet.
Claire, don't lose hope. I'm sure we're gonna find him. Damn it. You know what that means?
Yeah. Dinner time.
Claire, I think you should go.
Don't worry about me, Leon. You take care of yourself.
Claire, you need to go. Now!
Are you okay? Let's get through this. Both of us.
Marvin, I've got a situation here. I'm surrounded by zombies. Marvin, do you copy? Marvin! Damn it.
Hello, Fen Paws. How are you doing today? Likewise, actually playing Resident Evil 2 today, so yeah, hopefully you enjoy the video. I don't need it because I have the unlimited ammo, so I am good. Whoa! Yes, I have played this for the first time. Just trying to make some... I haven't really played it on hardcore though. So. Really trying to... Okay. Trying to beat this on a really difficult level, so yeah. Plus, I'm gonna also have to get some more health already. There we go. Actually, waiting for my mom to get out to give me a message, so because I'm gonna have to leave. But for right now, I'm staying on until I have to go. Yes, that is correct. I haven't played it on hard, so yeah, this will be definitely my first time. I gotta go on the third floor just to. Well, actually, no, second floor, not third. Wait, is it one more stairs? Yeah, one more stairs going down. Never know sometimes whenever they just sit there looking like. So if you play Jill, the story is different. The story actually involves with the little girl. Her name is Sherry, and then with Leon, it actually has it to where like you got to be with Ada. Now with the whole Mr. X thing, I think that's only with Leon. And with Jill, it's actually with William. So yeah, if that's what you're talking about, yes, there's really like a story gap. And I've noticed too that if you play Resident Evil 3, there's actually a time gap on that one as well. What I mean by time gap, it's like if you stop playing this for a little bit and then you realize that the guy that got bit, that's from Resident Evil 3. It just makes the zombies and lickers and stuff a little bit more difficult. And that's why I have like the unlimited ammo, because they're actually in-game content. So like if you have unlimited ammo, I mean just, go for it. But if you don't have unlimited ammo and you just want to wing it, I suggest that if you do play it without unlimited ammo, it's gonna be ridiculous. Like, your ammo consumption is gonna go away a lot quicker. Yeah. Cool. Right. So like this MP5 that I have over here, and then the handgun, they're unlimited. So that's what makes the game easier. But if you play without it, it's
still alive.
That's what will cause the game for it to be a little harder. But as long as you understand, I mean, that's a good thing too. Oh, and also this too, Fenpaws, but whenever you do play this as well, there's another thing that this game does. So you know how like on easy mode you get unlimited ink, but hard mode you actually get like insurmount of inks, so it's better to save your inks too. Like, see, I have 5 right now. I'm about to store it with this to make it 7. And if you want to, and you want to be really, really smart, then you also want to store as much health, because by the time you get near the end, you'll never know how hard it's going to be to fight like William and stuff too. So yeah, that's also the best option to use. Yeah. And if you want to, you could also dismember the... I'm playing this on the Xbox.
What the?
And I usually play this where like I can actually aim without having auto aim on, so yeah. Shit. Well, I'm playing this on the Series X, so unless you're talking about that kind of Xbox, otherwise I'll be thinking that you're talking about maybe the Xbox One or Xbox One X.
Oh.
I know I heard something. See if I can go back to the box. Was that it? I didn't hear nothing. So, it's a good thing, I guess. I heard that. So Fenpaw's, what do you play, my guy? Oh, okay. Well, that's cool. I mean, not everybody plays video games a lot. I'm only doing this, to, you know, because, like, I don't have work until, like, well, to be honest, I go back to work tomorrow, but I'm also going to try to do this as much as I can, maybe if we get off of work early, but if not, it'll be just on weekends. But I've been doing this quite a bit, even around times after we have a day off at work too, so I've been pretty consistent with it, so I'm glad you're on my stream though, bro. Oh really? What kind of Resident Evils do you play? Well, if you ever want me to, I mean, I could also stream the original Resident Evil. Kind of like one of the hardest. It's just that with that Resident Evil, I don't think I would be able to stream it on hard mode because of the simple fact that it's, you know, really ridiculous. And, you know, it's not like Resident Evil 2 to where, like, you can get unlimited ammo. Like I said, the ammo consumption is, like, really, really ridiculous. So without even unlimited ammo, Zero kind of actually interested me because I didn't know if there was like maybe something that happened before then. So when they came up with the Resident Evil Zero, I was like, oh wow. So there was an event that happened before Raccoon, before the mansion incident. So yeah, it was pretty interesting finding out that there was more to the story than anything. You know what? I feel so stupid because I kept passing all these by and I forgot. See, this is the lion. So, lion grass bird. Lion grass bird. Oh, that's one. Yes, I have, and it's really, really ridiculous. Like, the ending. So, I'll tell you this, okay? So, I've actually cheated on Zero, but when it was on the GameCube. But trying to cheat on, or trying to see if there's any way of cheating on the Zero for the Xbox, yeah, you can throw that really out the door. This is a unicorn. Because you are not going to be able to get out of it. Fish, scorpion, vase. But I know the ending is to where, like, I know there's, like, a few parts. I know there's, like, a few parts to where, like, if you try to play that on hard. Okay, let's just say this. Almost every Resident Evil that you play so far. No, just on the GameCube. On the Wii, I never played it on the Wii. I've only played it on the GameCube, though. Yes, I've only beaten it on the GameCube, but that's when GameCube also had like one of those cheat things too. So I didn't necessarily beat it by itself. I beaten it when they had like all them cheat discs. I'm sure if I try to play Resident Evil Zero now, it's gonna take me like hours to figure out what I need to do, because it's actually been a long time, and I have all the Resident Evils. I have from Resident Evil 0 to Resident Evil The Village. Have you played The Village yet? Why was it pointing up? Here's the last one. Woman, bow, snake. and Fempaws, if you want to know too, the liquors, if you the liquors too, like you can actually be really, really quiet, and next thing you know, the liquors won't hear you. Like you actually have to be like really, really quiet. I got slashed. Maybe I should have brung health. Yeah, no problem, dude. Are you serious? Oh, that's right. Wait, what? So maybe I should have saved, because I did all that basically for nothing. So what I'm going to do, chat, is I'm going to call it a day, because I actually have to go back to work. If you like this channel, please like and subscribe, and I will definitely try to make more videos as much as I can. If you want to look me up, I'm also on YouTube. I also play like Dead Space and all that other stuff. But I'm going to call it a day today, and I'll get back to playing Resident Evil 2. Like I said, I didn't realize that the game didn't have, you know, the autosave anymore. So now I have to deal with starting over. So I'll get back to starting over again, and yeah. So please like and subscribe my videos, and y'all have a great day. Bye-bye.